Today, we're going to go over how to make tea from plant to cup and everything in between. Stay tuned. Now, this particular skill is a request from one of our Patreon members. Robot Wolf, this one is for you. Now, if you're new to this channel and are interested in learning interesting new skills every week, why don't you consider subscribing below? So to make this tea, I got myself this little tea plant here. I've named him Herb. This is specifically a Camellia sinensis, I think is the name of the plant. It's a tea plant with the caffeine and all that. That being said, you can make this tea out of lots of stuff. You can make an herbal tea out of just mint you buy from the grocery store, lavender, sage, chamomile, whatever. You can make teas out of most plants, I think. Except for the toxic ones. You might want to avoid those. Now, it being kind of the middle of summer, it is late in the season for me to have been using this plant. I read that you want to get it early in the spring when brand new growth has started to come out. That being said, this did have some new growth on it. This was actually the size that I had bought it at, and it had grown pretty significantly. You can tell the new growth because it is on these green stalks here, as opposed to the rest of it, which has gotten old and woody looking. I've also read that when you harvest them, you only want to take like the top two most leaves of the new stuff. Like indoctrination, you want to get them when they're young. But I only have so many leaves on this to show you, so I went for this stalk that had four leaves on it, and then just picked through it to grab the new growth that I saw. Once harvested, I separated everything from the stalks, and then gave it a good wash. From here, we're gonna go ahead and steam them. Now, only for 2 minutes, we're not cooking them, we're just trying to make them a little more pliable. Once our 2 minutes is up, we wanna grab those bad boys and run them under some cold water to avoid them from cooking from the residual heat. Now all we gotta do is roll these bad boys up, either against like a cutting board or in between your palms. What you're looking for is to form these little tubes out of the leaves. Now I've seen people skip that steaming step and go right into the drying out step that we're about to do. I think if you just wanna shred it and have it kind of more crumbly, you probably don't have to go through that steaming step. I think it's only if you wanna use it as like the whole leaf. With that being said, from here I transfer them over to a baking sheet and put them in the oven at about 230 degrees Fahrenheit. For about 10 minutes. I just make sure I rotated them after 5 minutes to keep them drying out evenly. The result are these crispy little tubes of leaves that are ready to be made into tea. Now, if you do prefer kind of that ground up tea, what you can do is take these dried leaves and put them in just like a strainer sieve and then just grind them against the sieve and it will grind up the leaves. But I like putting them in this little jar here. I like how they look full. Like various amounts of this tea on my shelf will make it look like an apothecary of some sort. I love that. Good luck. And from here, if you want to prepare it, I mean, it's tea. You throw it in a cup, you boil up some water, and then you put said boiling water in said cup. Not rocket science, it's tea. And it is actually good tea. Like, look at the color, right? It is green, it is tea. I was setting out to make green tea, shazam. That being said, it doesn't taste as strong as the store-bought stuff, and I'm wondering if it's because like they usually include more leaves than I added into here, or if it's because I picked it later in the season. Any of you who actually make tea often, leave in the comments below what you think that might be. It's still good though, I really like it actually. It's very mellow, I enjoy it. And as I drink it, I do feel the caffeine coming in, so that part stayed, that's good. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, want to give me some of that thumbs up love, and again, don't forget to subscribe so you know when I release new content. In the meantime, though, keep leveling up, you.